People are speaking out concerning Mike Brown. They want justice. They don't want to see his killer on vacation while others are being arrested, taking a stand for justice and protesting. We'll take a look at that during this program. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help.
I was watching the news yesterday, and they're trying to get this Michael Brown all kind of just belittle him. And I'm so glad that that judge, whoever he was, just said, oh no, it ain't gonna happen. But what about this guy that shot him? He straight out shot this kid. He just straight out shot this kid. He can't get away with it. And we know that the prosecutor, actually his daddy got killed by a black man. So what are they doing? He ain't stepping down. This is bad. This is bad.
When this guy here is going to be
at least fingerprinted and appealed.
Right, fingerprinted, have a mugshot taken of him, and put in handcuffs. That's the only thing I want to see right now. And then I want to see him have justice done to him. I want to see the guy get some time or something. Yes, he's supposed to be in jail right now,
exactly.
Instead of just out living a life of luxury, you know?
Right, and getting paid.
I think they still paying this guy because, and after what he done, it's just, I don't understand it, you know? And I've worked for the government for 20 years. I don't understand it.
No.
Please bring justice and peace. Thank you.
Why are you taking a stand right now?
Because I have three boys of my own, and it could have very well have been mine. You know, and then just the whole presence of all of this, experiencing all of this. I've been experiencing this ever since I was little out here in Ferguson. It's just, they getting bolder and bolder and bolder. And it's time.
It's time they start executing justice and not people?
Yes, yes, it's time. It's like they seek and destroy us. It's like if we call for a domestic violence or anything in the neighborhood, it take them 10, 20 minutes to come. But for this, you see they on board already since one. It's not right. This is not right. So that's why I'm out here, and I'm going to continue to be out here. I've been out here every day since it started. So tear gas and all of that. I'm out here.
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Michael Brown was left dying on 4.5 hours on the pavement. That's an outrage, and there is no justice until that cop gets indicted and arrested and put in jail. And all the harassment and brutality dished out to people every day, black youth in particular, and then on top of that, all the repression against people that stepped out in the street bravely to take a stand, it's an outrage. And it actually points to something even bigger, that this is part of a whole, it's like the front end of a machine that is criminalizing our youth and building a pipeline into the prison, and this must end. It must stop. And this whole system, how much longer are we going to live when generations after generations who this system has no future for are locked up and brutalized and humiliated? That has got to stop. We need to get rid of this whole system, have a system that actually cherishes and brings forward the initiative and creativity of these youth to build a whole new world. We need a revolution, nothing less, to get there.
Why you out here?
Well, I'm out here because injustice is out here, Mr. Rice. I came over from Belleville. Same thing happening over here is happening in Belleville. The Mike Brown situation could have been in Belleville. So I'm coming over to lend support to this cause because I know we need a special prosecutor on this case.
Telling everybody we want to see him execute justice and not people.
Absolutely. It's too many unnecessary killings. Police brutality is getting out of hand, and we got to do something about it. I'm hoping it's going to send a resounding message to the Attorney General Eric Holder. He's going to make some changes here.
So that's why people are standing up, and they're trying to get the word out. They don't want Rob McCullough handling this case.
Absolutely don't want him handling it. Because of all the baggage that he brings, the situation with his father being the police, getting killed, he needs to recuse himself. He shouldn't have to wait on Governor Jay Nixon. He should do the right thing.
Step down as prosecutor. There's no way we're going to get justice with him in the position that he's in. I'm also here today to point out the fact that racism is alive and well, unfortunately, in the United States. And even though some of our social issues have been addressed, some of them, we have terrible institutional racism that's, to some people, they can't see it. They don't understand. But anyway, I'm here today to serve justice. Thank you.
What do you think about this? Why do you think they should execute justice and not people?
If it had been a regular citizen or something, they would have been indicted. Probably had them locked up by now, ready to go to court.
If they'd been a regular citizen,
he wouldn't
be on a paid vacation.
Right. He wouldn't be on no paid vacation. He wouldn't have to worry about his kids and nothing like that, how his family feel or nothing like that. Now, this lady got to worry about how her family feel, what's going to really happen at the end of this, but don't nobody know nothing.
Yeah.
See, this ain't no country where don't nobody know nothing. It's a too advanced country. Somebody should know something. But they ain't saying like, no, it ain't till October. It ain't till this, it ain't till that. Well, that boy's gone. So what you going to do now?
That's why the people are letting their voices be heard in the meantime. And if you'd like one of these badges, execute justice, not people, call us. 314-881-3218.
It's been a long time coming. It's been a long time coming. It's been going on for many years.
Yeah.
I know at least over 50 since I've been a kid. So I'm just out here just help where I can. Because I know my mother and father marched back in the early 60s. So I said, no, I ain't going to be out here like one of them. I'm going to be out here marching too. We need justice.
Right.
We need justice and peace. You know, it's a shame when you're working every day paying taxes. You can't ride up and down your own neighborhood. You can't walk up and down your own streets. That's a shame. Time like that is getting worse. Jesus speaks of these times. This is just the beginning. So this is just the beginning.
My name is Janine Maloff, and I am a correspondent with UK Progressive. UK Progressive is a news magazine that is based in London, England. It is seen throughout the entire United Kingdom and most of the European Union. I am doing a three-part series on the events in Ferguson. Two of the parts have already been aired. The first part was titled The Brutal Slaying of Mike Brown and the Police State in Ferguson. The second part was titled basically Apartheid USA, Police Militarization and Corporate Government. And this third part is going to focus on the actual leaders, the heroes and the zeros, the people pretending to be leaders when they're really not. It is an in-depth evaluation, and I urge everybody to look it up and then share it with everybody they know on Facebook. The more shares, the more people will continue to see it. I find this level of police action not only indecent, but it is absolutely the antithesis, the opposite of what should be a representative democracy. I do blame Governor Nixon, as well as our federal senators. Where is Senator McCaskill when people are being brutalized by the police? Why isn't there a federal investigation of policing here in St. Louis and St. Louis County as a whole, not merely Ferguson? Why isn't there a revocation of these programs that allow the police to basically be armed as SWAT teams? The mission of a soldier and the mission of a police officer are totally opposite. As Lawrence Korb once said, soldiers are trained to vaporize, not Mirandize. So please, look it up in UK Progressive. My name's Janine Maloff. It's a three-part series on the events in Ferguson. Thank you.
Execute justice, not people.
Only because it's not about race, it's just about simple equality, right? You know?
People having justice.
Yeah, just justice, period. We all need it. We all need it. Whether you black, white, Mexican, we all peoples. Yeah,
what do you think of the city of Ferguson? Their second highest source of revenue is all these tickets they gave people, raised over $2 million just ticketing people last year.
I just think the ticking and stuff, period, is a waste of time because it's bigger stuff out here that they need to be after, you know? Well,
they're sure all lined up to try to get the people that are taking a stand right now.
Yeah, I see them. They done drove by, flicked us off and everything. But, I mean, we still moving, we still standing here. It ain't even started yet, and we making people mad. That's good. Give us justice.
You want justice, not want to execute justice, not people.
Yes, yes, yes.
People are speaking up about executing justice, not people.
My name is Daoud Hussein. I just wanted to put it on record and see if anybody would look at it the way I see it, which don't really mean a whole lot, but in 07 or 06, when they marched and shut Highway 70 down, I was working on Highway 70. I was a union laborer in construction, and they was protesting that the labor unions and stuff was passing black people up and wasn't getting them hired, wasn't letting them join the union and get work. So when Al Sharpton and them shut the highway down, they were shutting down for them people to get jobs. When it was all said and done, what happened was them people got to go to school. Now, if you a man and you got 3 and 4 babies at home, you don't need to go to nobody's school. You need to go to work.
Amen.
But here's what a lot of people didn't know. When I was working on the highway in the summertime, the higher-ups, the supervisors and all them, and their cousins and friends, if they had children that got out of high school, then their children would come and work around us. We was making $21 and some an hour at that time. Now here a 17, 18-year-old kid come out of high school for the summer. He's making that kind of money all summer long. And here's a grown man trying to go to school to feed 3 or 4 babies. I didn't think that was right. I thought we got sold out or ran over and put under or whatever. Every time something happened, we seemed to get it quelled, a Band-Aid put on it, then we go back to normal till something new happened. Now, I want to say all that to say this, that if we don't really educate ourselves and learn better, this is going to be smooth over just like everything else. Now, here's what we really need to know. In the state of Missouri, which was one of the last states that abolished slavery, Dred Scott, in 1857, went to the courts to get his freedom because his master had died, his master said that he was free. So, but he had to go to the Missouri State Court to prove that he was a free man. They denied him of that freedom. Now, if you go and read the Dred Scott decision, it's going to talk bad about us as a people. But the judge, judge who wrote the decision, he wrote, his name was Judge Taney, he wrote that black people have no rights that white people have to honor. That's on the law books right now today in Missouri. And what we don't realize is that that man might know that, and he might feel justified that he had the right to kill that brother because he know we have no rights that they have to respect.
Black people all over America, I challenge you, get your head right and play the game the way it's supposed to be played. That's all this is anyway, it's just a game. And it's all about survival of the fittest. If you think you're gonna get out here and make these people change their minds about you and how they look at you, it's gonna have to start with how you look at yourself, and it's gonna have to start with how you view yourself. That's the reality, that's the truth. The Bible say we don't love the truth, we don't ever wanna hear the truth, but the truth to the matter is we got to change ourselves first. It shouldn't take no news crews, it shouldn't take Barack Obama, it shouldn't take no white boy or nobody coming over here to get the point across about what happened to that brother. It should have been clear and cut. We a good community. We don't bother nobody. We don't have no problems over here. We don't cause no problems. We mind our business. And this white cop came over here and blew this brother's brains out for no reason. That should have been an open and closed case. But when you got statistics that six, seven, eight, nine people are getting killed every night in the city of St. Louis, in the county of St. Louis, in Chicago, and it's black on black crime, when you got all these statistics out there, that's what people are gonna go by. When you go to apply for a job, they don't go interview your damn family. They don't go interview your friends. They look at your application, and whatever is on your application is basically how they come to their decision. When we out here killing each other, when we out here dogging each other out, when we out here disrespecting our men and women, our mothers and our fathers, when we out here doing all this stupid, ignorant stuff that we do, we setting up our application. We filling out our application. We submitting a resume. And when you give somebody your resume and they read it, that's what they go by. Black people, you need to start thinking, you need to start understanding that the world is the hiring manager. The world is the people who gonna determine whether you eat or whether you die.
Encouraging people to execute justice, not people.
Right, exactly.
And why do you feel strong about that?
Well, because we've been dealing with this for way too long, and it's time for us to stand up and do something about it. You know, it's the corruption out here in St. Louis County is just so widespread. It just doesn't make sense to me. So they need to stop doing it. And it's a time and a climate for us to get some change to take care of in St. Louis, Missouri.
What do you think about the officer that kills Mike Brown? He gets a paid vacation.
Paid vacation.
And people that speak
and
up.
And I can't even get a job.
Okay.
People that speak up and speak out against it.
Yep. We get arrested and we go to jail. But that's okay, though. You know, because God got us.
So that's why you got a badge. Execute justice, not
yes,
people.
Yes, not people. That's right. Uh-huh.
And people are speaking up about that. And if you'd like one of these badges, give us a call. 314-881-3218 or 314-421-3020 if you believe it's time to execute justice, not people. We're seeing too many people executed.
Too many people. Even the young man in the city. I hear that they were having a rally down at the city hall in St. Louis. You know, and I can actually say that the city police are a little different, but they're not any better than the rest of the folks that we marching against.
Hands and he said, he said, shoot me, shoot me. He obviously had mental problems.
Problems, exactly.
And they shot him down with 12 bullets.
Yes, 12 bullets.
Yeah.
Right. 12 bullets.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's sad.
You call that suicide by cops.
That's right. Exactly.
People get
that's
so
exactly
depressed, so down, that they start doing that.
Yes. Yeah. This is it's depressing out here.
And that's why we're fighting so hard to be sure they have shelter and the basic services they need so people don't get in that state.
Exactly. And I think that you're doing a wonderful job, and I do not want you to leave the city of St.
Louis. Keep praying for us.
They're
trying to shut us down October 21st, so we need people praying right now.
Okay. And I'll definitely keep praying.
God bless
okay.
you.
Okay. Thank you.
We strong. We watching all night long. We young, we strong, we marching all night long. We young, we strong, we marching all night long.
I'm Steve Smith. I'm here because I see, I'm from Jennings, and I see some of the injustices done to my neighbors. I've seen young men thrown down in my side yard, being searched for no good reason, then let go. It was just harassment. I've seen my neighbor, he's been stopped 4 times. He's a nice guy. He walks his dog for his parents every day. He doesn't deserve to be stopped. I just see all kinds of ill treatment of my neighbors. And I'm just angry enough. I can't take it anymore. And so I decided I had to do something.
Tell us why you feel it's important to execute justice and not people.
Well, I think, you know, innocent people shouldn't be hurt in a situation like this. And this is what we're involved in now because we can't get a justice verdict or get an answer about what's going on. If you're going to charge them, you're going to charge them. If you ain't going to charge them, just tell the people so we can find out how we can heal this situation. This is getting to be out of hand and it's going to get very serious out of hand. That's why it's very important that the clergy is out here trying to conduct peace, and we can't even find peace within the clergy.
Wow.
So, I mean, it's getting very serious.
The Bible says be angry, but sin not, right?
Right, sin not. You know, you got wisdom and knowledge that the Lord has gave you, and if you use your wisdom and knowledge, we wouldn't have what we got going on today. And then again, because we don't get involved in our politics and everything, that's what happens in this case, you know, because we're going through a scenario matter, excuse me, and that's what's very important.
People speaking out and speaking
out. People
speaking
out and being heard, you know. You can preach the truth until you preach yourself into the ground. And that's what it's almost getting
like
up to.
Looks like there's lots of police out here to stop the protesters.
There's more police than protesters, I think.
Out here trying to stop them.
Missouri yet, State, everybody is here.
But yet the man that killed Mike Brown
is not here.
He's on a paid vacation.
Yeah. Well, but look what he's putting the whole world through. You know, God was never in confusion. And this is confusion. He wouldn't get involved. Yeah, and it's a great thing.
Thank you very much.
Hey, how y'all doing? My name is Larry Malone. I reside in St. Louis, Missouri. I go to school. You hear me? I'm a black, young, African-American male. I feel like, what's going on is completely corrupt. They need to go ahead and arrest this Darren Wilson. They throwing out other stories to overshadow his case. But me, myself, I feel like all this was set up, to be honest. You know what I'm saying? And the same thing is gonna go on. We need to fight. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be a war. This standing here is protesting. They're gonna try to just arrest us flat out. So it's gonna be a war. Understand? I mean, justice, no peace. You feel me? They saying it right there, flat out. I got love for all my black folks, man. It's real. We need to stick together. We need to come together as one. A straight fight, because if we don't, same thing is gonna happen. It's gonna repeat itself. Law enforcement gonna keep killing us. Is this what they want? They want to control us, and I feel like we just gotta fight. That's all I believe, man. God is with us. Trust me, God is with us all, my brother.
Well, we're hearing from the people. What about you? Do you believe that it's time to stop executing people and start executing justice? I think that time's come, don't you think?
Yes, I think so, and thank you for the badge, Larry. I think it's way time, to stop this injustice, man. People are getting fed up with this stuff, man, and they just need some results, man. They need some results. And I hate what it took to somebody, a youngster, to get killed to bring this about. But it's all a plan, man. It's all a part of God's plan, man. In revolution, somebody got to die. Somebody's got to keep on going, man,
If you'd like one of these badges, execute justice and not people, call us. 314-881-3218. That's 314-881-3218. Or 314-421-3020. So I'd just like one of those badges, execute justice, not people. If you believe it's time to execute justice, not people, let's speak up, let's speak out. The hour is late, we can't continue to stand back, and it'd be business as usual. There's too many people hurting, there's too many people that are being hurt.
Please
too
call.
Many need. Please call. Yes, if you'd like the badge, remember you can call now, 314-881-3218, and get a free badge. Execute justice, not people.
West Floss? Floss, South Floss. But you got to shoot their rise that way. Go that way. You can go there.
What I think about it, it's injustice. Mm-hmm. People are getting tired of being treated like animals. We are all one people, regardless of skin color. But it's gotten to the point now where you are just like, you're a profile. You don't feel safe walking down the street. You don't feel safe with your family. You don't feel safe doing anything. And police see you, he just target you, pick you out of a crowd, and just harass you. I've been harassed for so many years. I know I've been down this road before so many times. So I'm tired of seeing the injustice that people are suffering from. And it's time for it to stop. And if this will make any kind of change in the situation, doing this today, just to show support for Michael Brown, then I'm here. I'm willing to do my part.
You feel like it's wrong?
Pardon me?
The police officer that killed Michael Brown and executed him, he's on a paid vacation right now.
It's been going on for centuries. It's been going on forever. They don't want justice for us. The police chief dug up dirt on Mike Brown the same day he released the police name. Now, how cold was that? Yeah. How cold was that?
That they would do that.
That he would do that. The family's grieving, but yet and still he waited until the last D-Day to do that for everybody to see, to try to discredit this young man. This young man had his hands up. You don't, you go hunting, you see an animal, if an animal takes his hand up and got the gun, you feel sorry and sympathy. I can't shoot him, you know. You give him a chance, let him run away, let me at least do something for him. But this is just so much injustice, man. It's time for this stuff to stop.
And people are speaking up about it.
Everybody, it's going all over the world. It's not just here in St. Louis, it's all over the world, man.
How do you keep from getting bitter rather than better? What keeps you going?
What keeps me going is a higher power.
Depending on God and His grace.
What go around, come around. Now, even though when the trial for Mike Brown and this police just shot him, even regardless of the outcome, the man upstairs has a plan. Nothing happens on the face of this earth that you don't rectify for it. It's gonna be paid for. What goes around, come around, because all this protest and everything we are doing now, even if we don't get justice, we don't see justice right now, high power will, he will pay for that before he leave this earth.
So that's, we got to keep that faith, don't we?
Let's keep the faith, man. High power.
People are speaking up and speaking out more and more, believing in that higher power.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Justice. It's the right thing to do.
Do you feel people need to speak up at this time?
Absolutely. Anytime kids are getting murdered on the street without any weapons on them, yeah, that's definitely a time to speak out. I have a son. He's 17, so it could have been my baby laying down there.
So you're telling the police to execute justice, not people?
Absolutely.
You can up right now?
Yeah, I think so. I think there's a, I think you can move mountains when you have a lot of voices. I think people tend to listen to a collective groups as opposed to individual.
And I think God wants us executing justice, not people, Rodney.
Right, absolutely. No one deserves to get murdered.
and people are speaking up. They're speaking out. And they're letting them be known. They want justice. And we just want to help get their message out. You're saying indict and jail the killer cop, fire the police chief, full accounting of what happened immediately, fight the power and transform the people for revolution.
That's right, because we need some peace. You can't just be out here just killing people because they black men, and they don't, race don't even have nothing to do with it, just a man or woman in general. We pay our, what, our taxes and everything. We deserve to speak out on what we think should be right. It's not always what they agree upon and everything else. We got a right to speak and say what we want to as well. It's not right. You can't just go around here doing this. So everybody who has a gun has a right to just execute somebody when they hands is up? No, that's not right. You don't do that. We vote and everything else. And I hope that they get the mayor out of office and everything else that goes along. I stand behind them full accord. I really do. And I pray that we do get justice. If we don't, then it won't be no peace. I'm not gonna sleep, and I hope won't nobody else sleep. That's all I have to say.
Well, I'd like to know how you feel about this. Feel free to contact me, Larry Rice, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. Let me know how you feel. If you like one of those badges that say execute justice and not people, let me know. I'd be happy to send you one. You can write me at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, or you can actually call us at 314-881-3218. That's 314-881-3218. People are lining up. People are speaking up. People are speaking out.